Hi students, welcome back to Next Gen Online Tuition. So now we are with our exercise 2.4 factor theorem of 9th grade, and the chapter is same polynomials of NCERT syllabus that we are already know. Okay, so the factor theorem deals with how to factorize a given polynomial. The polynomial could be any quadratic or a cubic polynomial. So we are going to solve both type of problems today. Okay, so this is factor theorem definition. If P of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than or equal to 1 and a is any real number, then we have two conditions. X minus a is a factor of P of x if P of a is equal to 0, which means in the first type the factor has been already given, like determine which of the following polynomial has x plus 1 a factor. Okay, this is exercise 2.4, first problem. So the factor is already given. We have to find whether this factor satisfies this polynomial, cubic polynomial. This we have already done in our previous video. It's a screenshot from the previous video. So what we have done there, we made it as a zero polynomial, x plus 1 to 0. We found the value as x is equal to minus 1 and substituted the minus 1 values in the x value here. And we have determined whether it is a factor or not, which means if we get 0 as our answer, it is a factor. Otherwise, not. If not 0, it is not a factor, which we have derived already. You can refer the previous videos. So condition 1 we have solved. Now we have condition 2, that is P of A is equal to 0 if x minus 1 is a factor of P of x, which means we have to factorize the polynomial and determine the possible factor, which means this factor will not be given. X plus 1 is a factor. This question does not contain the factor part. Only the question part we have, that is they will give the quadratic or cubic polynomial. We need to determine the factor. How? This is our sample problem. Okay, type 2 sample problem. Type 1 is already solved. Type 2. So we need to factorize and find the possible factors. Okay, we have two methods. One, by using factor theorem. We can factorize using factor theorem, or else we have splitting method, which means we need to split the middle factor, middle term, and find the possible factor. How? Let's see. So this is for quadratic polynomial, which means my first term will be x square. If that is x cube, that is cubic polynomial that we are already aware of. Okay, so 20x square minus 9x plus 1. We need to multiply 20 and 1 first. This is our first step. 20 and 1. Okay, first step, we need to multiply our first and last term, and the order should be rearranged. If the order is not in the proper manner, we need to rearrange x square, x, and at the last we have the constant polynomial, constant term. Okay, so 20 into 1, 20. Now we need to find the possible factors. What are the possible factors of 20? That is, which two number when get multiplied give the value 20? 1 and 20. 1 multiplied by 20 is 20. 2 with 10. 2 times 10 is 20. 3, no, it won't satisfy the 20. 4 fives are 20. 6, again 5 table, we have 5 times 4, so don't need, no need to write again. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, again 10 times 2. Okay, now we can stop. After 10, we are not required to check after 10. Okay, so which two numbers will give me the value 9? We can add or subtract, anything we can do, but it should give the value 9. Out of these three possible factors, 4 and 5 give me the value 9. Can you understand? 1 and 20 won't give, 2 and 10 won't give, 4 and 5, if I add or subtract, I get the value 9. So 20 can be split to 4 times 5, since I have the sign plus into plus here. So no need to specify, and I need to get minus 9. So if I have minus 4 and minus 5 only, my result will be minus 9. We need to put the sign accordingly. Okay. If I multiply minus 4 and minus 5, also 20 is my result. That won't change. And minus 4 and minus 5 gives me minus 9. Okay. So on these two factors, on multiplying, I should get the first and third term. And on adding, I will get the middle term. So only 4 and 5 satisfies both the condition. So my third step is, I found out the possible factor minus 4 and minus 5. Now we need to split up. I need some space here. So this is my third step. Split accordingly. 20x square minus 5x minus 4x minus 4 minus 5. So this minus 9 is splitted and written as minus 5x minus 4x plus 1. Now take the common term outside. 5x. So 5 times 4. 5 4s are 20, and one more x because we have x square minus 1. So similar 4x minus 1 we need to get here. Fine. So split it accordingly. 4x, here 4x, minus sign we have, so put minus 1. 1 times 4x is 4x minus 1. Minus into minus plus 1. Alright. Now join the terms. 5x minus 1. 4x minus 1. So these two are the possible factor for this quadratic polynomial. Okay. Shall we move to the first exercise of 2.4? Sorry, fourth one. 1, 2, and 3 we have finished already. This is our first subdivision of fourth sum. Twelve x square minus 7x plus 1. Factorize. Just the question is factorize. We need to find the factor as before. First step, multiply first term and third term. My answer is 12. What are the possible factors? I'll put here. 12 into 1, 12. Since both the sign are plus, we need to be careful with the sign also. Since both are plus, the resultant answer 12 also remains plus 12. What are the possible factors? Possible factors of 12 which satisfies the middle term 7. So 1 and 12 gives me 12. 2 and 6 gives me 12. 3 and 4 gives me 12. 4 and 3 again, 5, 6, 7, 8, that's all. So which two number gives me the value 7? I can add or subtract anything. That is 3 and 4. Since I have minus sign here, 12 can be split as minus 3, minus 4. So minus 3 added with minus 4 gives me minus 7. Minus 3 multiplied with minus 4 gives me 12. Both the conditions are satisfied. On multiplying, I get 12. On adding, I get minus 7. Third step. Split it. 12x square minus 3x minus 4x plus 1. Minus 7 is written as minus 3x and minus 4x. 3 outside, 4x minus 1. So here 4x minus 1 must be the common term here, minus 1. So 3x minus 1 and 4x minus 1. Alright, these are my common term. So these are the factors as well for the above polynomial question also. Alright, shall we move to the second subdivision? 2x square plus 7x plus 3. So we can, without doing all these 1, 2, 3 steps, we can directly split and write. 2 with 2 and 3 gives me 6. Possible factor which gives me the 7 value is 6 times 1. Right? 2 and 3 is a factor. 6 and 1 are the factors. And 2 and 3, that's all, no more factors. So only 6 and 1 gives me the value 7. Since I have plus sign everywhere, it's very simple. Now split the middle term, 6x plus x plus 3, x plus 3, which means I'm taking 2x outside. 2x is a common term in the first two terms. We are splitting 4 terms into 2 and 2. Here x plus 3 plus 1, 2x plus 1, x plus 3. These two are my factors for the second subdivision. Let's move on to third one. So fine, 6 multiplied by 6 is 36. Since I have minus here, gives me minus 36. 2 factor which satisfies 5. So what are the possible factors? Start with 2. 2 and 18. 3 and 12. 4 and 9. 5, 6 and 6. 7, 8, 9. 9 fours are 36 is again 4 and 9. We have already here. So which 2 number gives me 5? Out of these, 9 and 4. Okay, so 9 and 4 plus 5 we have. So we need to change the sign accordingly. Because if I put minus 9 here, okay, minus 9 and plus 4 gives me minus 5. minus 9 plus 4 gives me minus 5, but the middle term is not minus 5, it's plus 5. So the bigger number takes the plus value. Okay, this is wrong. So plus 9 and minus 4 gives me simply 5, because the bigger value takes the plus sign. So 5 also gets plus. Plus 9 and minus 4 is minus 36. Both the conditions satisfied. Now split it. 6x square plus 9x minus 4x minus 6. So it gives me, take 3x outside. These two term gives me 3x as a common term. 2x plus 3. Here also we need to get 2x plus 3 value. So minus 2. Minus 2 with 2x gives me minus 4x. Minus 2 and plus 3 gives me minus 6. Now combine the terms. 3x minus 2, 2x plus 3. These are the two factors. Okay, just make it speed to factorize. On solving more and more problems, we need to finish with only 3 steps like this. So the first time we have solved step by step. Down the line, you have to pick up the speed so that you can save time in during exams. Okay, here 12 gives me minus 12 because minus 4 is there. Which two terms gives me minus 1? Since I don't have any constants there, I take the value as minus 1. Directly 4 and 3 gives me 1. Since it takes the minus value, the bigger number takes the minus sign. Minus 4 and plus 3. So minus 4 and plus 3 gives me minus 12. Minus 4 plus 3 gives me minus 1. Both the condition satisfied. Split it. 3x square minus 4x. Sorry. Because 3x square and 3 have to be returned next, because we have to take the common term outside. 3x square and minus 4x we can't write, because 3 and 4 don't have any common terms. 3x square plus 3x minus 4x minus 4. So the common term here is 3x, x plus 1. We need to make it as x plus 1 as a common term. Gives me minus 4. 3x minus 4, and the middle term is common, is x plus 1, which is the factor for fourth subdivision. Alright. Okay. This is up to which we have completed quadratic polynomial factorization has been completed so far. So what if my first term is a cubic polynomial? Okay, x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. We can't directly factorize as we did before, so we need to find at least one possible factor by trial and error method. Okay, so x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. So here we can solve it in two methods, type 1 and type 2. Let's solve in both the methods. So x square is a common term, x minus 2, and here x minus 2 should be my second term, okay, minus 1, x square minus 1, combining the term, x minus 2. And this gives me a square minus b square pattern. You are aware of a square minus b square equal to a plus b, a minus b. So split it accordingly. X plus 1, x minus 1, x minus 2. Okay. So these are the possible factors. It's a direct method. Fine. And we have one more method. It's a little long process, but you should aware of both the process. First, we need to find at least one possible term. Okay, so my constant here is 2. What are the possible factors of 2? 2 and 1. So here we don't know the sign. Okay, 2, whether 2 takes plus or minus. So we need to take it as plus 1, minus 1. Plus 2, minus 2. Okay, these four are the possible factors of 2. Okay, since we have a cubic x cube here, we are not multiplying 2 and 1 here. We are just taking the single term 2. The possible factors are minus 1, 1, minus 2, 2. And now we need to check all these four terms with the given equation, with the given cubic polynomial. First, I am taking 1. 1 cube minus 2, again 1 plus 2. Okay, 1 minus 2. Sorry, this is not minus 2. Here we have minus x, so simply minus 1. Plus 1 minus 1 minus 2 plus 2 gives me 0. So P of 1 satisfies the condition 0. X minus 1 is a possible factor. X minus 1 in the previous problems, B we have given in the question as x minus 1 is a factor. Now this is the reverse method. Already we have found the possible factor, and out of these four factors, one satisfies the condition. So x minus 1 is a factor. So x minus 1 equal to 0 gives me x as 1 value. Right? This is our normal method. Since x minus 1 is a possible factor, we need to x minus divide. We need to now divide the polynomial. X minus 1 with x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. Fine? Can you understand me? X minus 1 is a possible factor we have found. This is step 1 and this is our step 2. Since our problem is not yet completed, we need to find the remaining factors of this cubic polynomial. Now, dividing the first term. This polynomial division we have seen already. X cube by x gives me x square. This is first term of quotient. Write x square, x cube minus x square, plus minus. It cancels. X square minus x, and first term again minus x square, again divided with the same x, minus x, gives me second term of quotient. This is my first quotient and this is my second quotient. X square minus x minus x square minus x plus plus. Sorry, this is plus x. So gives me minus 2x plus 2. And again, fresh term, minus 2x divided with x again. Minus 2 gives me third term of quotient. Minus 2. Minus 2x plus 2. Sign change gives me 0. So my other terms are, my other factors are, x minus 1 is my first factor, x square minus x minus 2. Now for this quadratic polynomial, we need to repeat the previous steps as we did before. So minus 2, split it 2 and 1 because I have only minus 1 in the middle. So minus 2 and plus 1. Minus 2 and plus 1 gives me minus 2. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Satisfied both the condition. X minus 1, x square, split the terms. Minus 2x plus x minus 2. X minus 1. Here, x minus 2 is my common term because I have x here. X, x minus 2 plus 1. Plus 1 here. X minus 1. X plus 1. X minus 2. So these three terms we have as a factor of the given cubic polynomial. Right? Quadratic method is different and cubic method is entirely different. We have to solve using all these methods. Like step 1 and step 2. Alright? Okay. Thank you. That's all for today's class. And the next upcoming classes, we can solve more cubic polynomials. Feel free to WhatsApp at this number for any clarifications. Okay? Thank you, children. Have a nice day.